pitch. So, and he's done a remarkable job defensively. He's like a cat back home plate.
Good numbers against Andy Benes, 6-for-12 with a couple of home runs. Of course, he used to catch Benes when Andy was pitching at San Diego. Wheels here at St. Louis, the ballpark looks different. Grass and dirt now, a lot of improvements, and certainly a different-looking Cardinal team.
Absolutely, Harry. They are not going to be the running Redbirds as we used to know them in this ballpark. They brought over a very high-profile manager from the American League in Tony La Russa. You see he's added a bunch of coaches that he's familiar with and a lot of guys from the American League. So they're going to be a very, very different team here in St. Louis, especially with this new ballpark. You know, we were used to them being the running Redbirds. They had AstroTurf. They had huge dimensions. Well, as you said, grass and dirt now, and they've brought the fences in a little bit. They put some fly ball hitters in the lineup. They're going to try and hit more home runs and score that way than the way they used to.
Terry Mulholland for the Phillies and Andy Benes for St. Louis. Starting lineups for you right after these messages.
Baseball is being brought to you by the Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages. Hungry? Grab the genuine Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages and have dinner delivered right to your door. By Mellon PSFS, the official bank of the Phillies, featuring full-service evening and seven-day banking. Your local Chevrolet Geo dealers. And by Independence Blue Cross and Pennsylvania Blue Shield, the insurance companies you can lean on.
Training, more pedaling,
less pollution,
more sweat, more hills,
less pollution,
more sore thighs.
Who's reducing air pollutants by over 3 million tons a year and donating natural gas vehicles to the Olympics? PICO Energy, proud member of the American Gas Association's Clean Air Team, official sponsor of the 1996 Olympics.
If you've been thinking about Ford Escort, think fast. Because right now, you can get $1,000 cash back or 4-8 financing on every 3-door Escort or GT in stock. Whether you choose manual or automatic, you get standard dual airbags, AM/FM stereo, AC, and more. With 4-8 financing or up to $1,000 cash back, Ford Escort is still priced less than Neon.
Your Ford dealers, the driving ones.
A leader in quality and value. No wonder more Escorts are still on the road than any other small car.
Back at Busch Stadium in St. Louis, first of a four-game series, the Phillies and the St. Louis Cardinals. A very pleasant night here. The wind will be a little bit of a factor. It looked like the ball was jumping toward right field tonight. Lineup cards being handed out at home plate by Jim Fregosi and Tony La Russa in his first year as manager of the Cardinals. Cowboy Joe West will call the balls and strikes tonight. Rich Rieker at first, Jeff Kellogg at second, and Paul Runge will umpire at third. Grass and dirt here at Busch Stadium in St. Louis, and park looks nice, Whitey.
Beautiful. They have all this stuff planted around the outfield. That looks beautiful again. They've changed the bullpens. Of course, they've changed a lot of things here. Cardinals bullpen is in kind of dead left field here, and the Phillies is to the left of the Cardinal bullpen. New seats right behind home plate. They cost $100 a piece a night.
And they got Homer's Landing out there over the Cardinal bullpen. Fans can...
Who's Homer?
Dine and... Well, that's well, a that's ball that goes that, out of the ballpark.
Okay.
Way. A home run.
Makes sense.
Dugouts are bigger. A lot more comfortable. St. Louis so far is 4-4 in the early going this season. They played a lot of close games. Five of their eight games so far have been decided by one run.
An extra inning game they've yeah. played a lot of. They've been three out of the last five have been extra inning.
We're seeing Andy Benes tonight. Yesterday, Alan Benes pitched quite a ball game. The younger brother of Andy, who's In the Cardinals starting rotation, he beat Montreal 4-1 and struck out 11 in so doing.
Tony La Russa is a lawyer.
Yes.
Has an MBA also. I don't know how he ever wound up in baseball, but he didn't have a great playing career. He was an infielder.
This is his 18th year as manager among active managers. He's won more games than every other manager except Norristown's Tom Lasorda. Jim Fregosi's starting lineup tonight has Lenny Dykstra center field leading off. Mickey Morandini second base, bat second. Jim Eisenreich left field hitting third. Todd Zeal, the third baseman, bats fourth. Mark Quinn right field hitting fifth. Benito Santiago leads the Phillies and runs batted in so far, will catch and hit sixth. Gene Shaw, first baseman, bats seventh. Kevin Stocker, the shortstop, hitting eighth. And Terry Mulholland pitching and batting ninth. Facing Andy Benes.
Yeah, Andy Benes is a power pitcher. He throws a lot of good fastballs. I think he's mixed them up a little more in the last couple of seasons because he's had to. He just couldn't get by with that one power pitch.
You see his career record against the Phillies, 9-3. He's beaten the Phillies more than any other team in his career with 9 wins and a good ERA lifetime against the Phillies at 3.09. Kind of unusual that he's being beaten the Phillies more often because the Phillies have never been in his division. But Benes, while with San Diego, threw a lot of good games against the Phillies. David Bell at third base, Royce Clayton shortstop, Luis Alcea at second base, Gary Gaetti at first for St. Louis. Pat Borders is the catcher, the outfield from left to right, Ron Gant, Ray Langford, and Willie McGee. Jim Fregosi and bench coach John Vukovic, Jim Eisenreich ready to swing the bat. Cardinals are yet another team that Eisenreich has good success against. A lifetime 361 hitter is Eisenreich against St. Louis. Lenny Dykstra leads it off. Dykstra's off to a great start, hitting at 370. He is tied for third in the National League in runs scored with 9. Fourth in slugging percentage, 9th in on-base percentage. Lifetime not a real good hitter against Benes. He's a 206 lifetime hitter against Andy Benes with 1 home run. One strike to Lenny Dykstra. Game time temperature, Whitey, 80 degrees. Can you believe it? Only about 50 degrees warmer than it was yesterday in Pittsburgh.
Oh, brother.
One and two to Lenny Dykstra.
Joe West gave Benes that high strike. Kind of unusual. Joe's a good umpire.
Fly ball into left field. Ron Gant over toward the line. Boy, that ball carries. He didn't hit that ball all that well, and Gant has to go back near the fence to take it. That gives you an indication of how the ball is going to carry to left field here tonight.
It looked to me like in batting practice, Harry, that it was carrying everywhere. I mean, balls were shooting out of here to all fields.
Yeah. Mickey Morandini batting at 286. Has good lifetime numbers against Benes, 379 lifetime hitter against this right-hander. One ball and no strikes to Morandini. Bouncing ball to Alcea, who throws Morandini out. Two quick outs for Benes here in the first, and that'll bring up Jim Eisenreich. Eyes is batting at 417. Although he hit St. Louis pitching well, he has not hit Bennis well in his career. He's 2-for-13 against Andy Bennis. Bennis was the first player selected in the June 88 draft out of Evansville, Indiana by San Diego. Traded last year by the Padres to Seattle. He was 4-7 with San Diego, 7-2 with Seattle. Coming over here as a free agent. Got the breaking ball over, one ball and two strikes to Eisenreich.
That's his slider. He also throws a harder slider than that. He took a little off that pitch.
Pops it in the shallow left. Gant makes a nice tumbling catch, and that will retire the side. Good play by Ron Gant. No runs, hits, errors, and none left after one half. Bills nothing. St. Louis coming to bat.
Grand Bahama, the islands of the Bahamas. It just keeps getting better.
Call American Express Travel at 1-800-AXP-2796.
Recently, the camera shop went all blue by offering their employees health plans for Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
We couldn't be happier with our all blue coverage. Our employees make it a point to exceed our customers' expectations. And we get the same level of commitment from the Blues. Our employees and their families think the coverage is great, and so do I.
Go all blue with personal choice, Keystone HMO, or our traditional plan from Independence Blue Cross and Pennsylvania Blue Shield, the folks you can lean on.
Nobody does it like you.
The new Hoover Steam Vac Deluxe with 5-brush agitator. Compared to professionals, there's no comparison.
Nobody does it like you.
Back at Busch Stadium in St. Louis, we go to the bottom half of the first inning. Phillies down 1-2-3 in the top half, and Tony La Russa's lineup tonight will have Luis Alicea at second base leading off. Royce Clayton, the shortstop, at second. Ray Langford in center field hitting third. Ron Gant, who has awesome numbers against Mulholland, 353 lifetime, 4 homers. He'll play left field and hit fourth. Willie McGee in right field bats fifth. Gary Gaetti, the first baseman, hitting sixth. Pat Porter's catches batting seventh. David Bell at third base hits eighth. And Andy Bennis, the pitcher, batting ninth, facing Terry Mulholland.
Terry got a win his last time out. He had that one bad inning in the fifth. He said he lost his concentration when Ricard, the pitcher, got a hit off of him. Said he's too old to do that, but he did it anyway. But he did get the win.
7-4 lifetime against St. Louis. One ball and no strikes. The switch hitting Luis Alicea. Alicea back in a Cardinal uniform. He played at Boston last year. Line drive right at Kevin Stocker. One down, and that'll bring up Royce Clayton. Royce Clayton, the shortstop. Defensively behind Mulholland, Todd Zeal at third, Kevin Stocker shortstop, Mickey Morandini second, Gene Shaw at first. Benito Santiago catching, Jim Eisenreich, Lenny Dykstra, and Mark Whitten in the outfield from left to right. Kind of a shortstop controversy here, and longtime outstanding shortstop, Ozzie Smith. Now they've got Clayton over here. He's a good shortstop in his own right. And, of course, a whole lot younger at 26. Right now they don't have to worry about it because Ozzie's been put on the disabled list, the 15-day disabled list.
Ozzie's now 41. That makes a difference.
One ball and two strikes to Royce Clayton. Clayton hitting at 281. struck him out. So Mulholland gets Clayton for out number two, and that'll bring up Ray Langford.
And Ozzie Smith looks good, looks the same.
Yeah.
Hurt, as you said.
Put on the 15-day disabled list to make. And they have called up Aaron Holbert from Louisville. Here's Ray Langford hitting 265. This guy always seems to hurt the Phillies, yet I look at his career numbers against the Phillies, and they're not all that impressive. 269. I guess that 269 that he hits against the Phillies always seems to come in clutch situations.
Yeah, it's a hard 269. He goes along, you know, he goes along, Ray Langford. Everybody thinks he should have been a better ball player. And it seems like he should have. You know, he's strong, he's fast, quick bat.
Two balls and a strike to Ray Langford with two outs and no base runners. Two and two.
He had made up his mind he's going to get a pitch fastball to hit, and made up his mind to swing. Well, he didn't get the fastball. Bad pitch low and away, a slider.
Into left field, Jim Eisenreich waits, and he'll put it away. And Terry Mulholland has a 1-2-3 inning. No runs, hits, errors, and none left after one. Nothing.
Time. You never seem to have enough of it. Gotta go here, gotta be there. So when do you have time to bank? Midnight? Sunday morning? Why not? At Mellon,
thank you for calling.
We offer 24-hour telephone banking services, hundreds of ATMs, full-service offices, plus many Acme Market offices open 7 days a week. Sound convenient? Call 1-800-MELLON-24 and find out how you can bank where you want, when you want. Mellon PSFS.
The revitalized, re-energized Gantide St. Louis Cardinals come in Friday, April 19th at 7:35. Saturday the 20th at 7:05, and Sunday the 21st at 1:35, when it's the Fanatics' birthday, and all fans 14 and under receive a big beach towel, compliments of Tasty Cake. Then Pittsburgh pops in Monday, April 22nd at 7:35, and Tuesday the 23rd at 1:05 for a Mellon PSFS Business Person Special. Call 463-1000.
Only one station in Philadelphia plays nothing but classic hits. 102.9 MGK. Eric Clapton. Paul McCartney.
102.9 MGK.
Rod Stewart.
Wake up, Maggie.
The Stones. Elton John.
102.9 MGK.
The Police. Billy Joel. When you want the classics, turn on Philadelphia's only classic hit station. 102.9 MGK.
After one inning of play, the Phils nothing, St. Louis nothing. Upcoming telecasts of Phillies baseball include tomorrow night's game with the Cards at 8 and Saturday afternoon's game beginning at 2 right here on WB17. Todd Zeal leads it off for the Phils. Zeal hitting at 160. Signed as a supplemental pick by St. Louis between the second and third rounds in the June 86 draft. Signed as a catcher originally. One strike to Zeal. One and one. One ball and two strikes. Bouncing ball hits softly to third, and Bell will retire Zeal. One down, that'll bring up Mark Whitten. Stephen Bell, the son of Buddy Bell, manager of the Tigers.
Third generation of Bells. Gus Bell started it.
Right.
Buddy and then Dave here.
Witness hitting at 273. Lifetime against Andy Bennis. He's 1-for-6. Bennis is throwing strikes, getting ahead of the hitters so far. One ball and one strike to Mark Whitten. As Will's mentioned in the opening, this team no longer the running Redbirds. They used to use their speed, steal a lot of bases. But a different look ball club. They're more of a power hitting team now. Phillies, oddly enough, are tied for second in the league in stolen bases here in the early going with 13 of them. Phillies and the Dodgers each have 13. Cincinnati leads the league with 17. The Cardinals have just 8.
Phillies have won 2 games, 2 of their 4 games with 3-run homers. That was Earl Weaver's old philosophy, the 3-run homer. Santiago and Whitten won ball games.
Missing with a slider, it's a full count now to Mark Whitten with one out and no base runners. Ground ball hit to Alisea. Takes care of Whitten. That's 2 down, and up will bring up Benito Santiago. Santiago, the only Philly in the lineup with real good numbers against Bennis lifetime. Of course, he caught him at San Diego. Then when Benito went over to Florida, batted against him as well as at Cincinnati last year. 6-for-12 with a couple of home runs off Bennis. One ball and no strikes. One to Benito Santiago. Low and away, 2-1 to him. The end of the bat, and Langford will put it away to retire the side. No runs, hits, errors, none left. We go to the bottom of the second. It's nothing, nothing.
Coming up on Inquirer News tonight, how could it happen? A 7-year-old girl died piloting a plane across country trying to set a record. Plus, for the first time in 14 years, Israeli aircraft attack a training center for Hezbollah guerrillas in the city of Beirut. And we'll visit a local high school powerlifting team that's headed to the national competition. Details on those stories, plus the weekend forecast and sports after the game on Inquirer News tonight.
If you've got spring fever, your Toyota dealer has the cure.
It's called the best car built in America, the Toyota Camry. Lease it for just $229 a month with all the extras you want included, like air conditioning, automatic transmission, AM/FM cassette, and dual airbags. Or buy and get low financing on Camry and Avalon, the luxury 6-passenger car from Toyota.
But hurry, spring fever doesn't last forever.
Just think about it. A McCain 5-minute fry. It's like boom! I mean, you're in, you're out. It's the ultimate rush. I mean, I, being a McCain potato, was born for this job. I don't know. I just have this need for speed or something. It's such a rush.
And it's kind of nice, too, because for the moms. Because there's less time cooking, and there's more time for doing mom things.
Oh, for crying out loud.
What?
McCain 5-Minute Fries. Real fries from the oven in just 5 minutes. McCain, the world's number one French fry.
Hello, spring. Hello, sun. Hello, first of five Mellon PSFS business person specials. Tuesday, April 23rd, when the Phillies play the Pirates at 105. Call 463-1000. And when the lady says hello, order tickets.
Fanatic's birthday coming up on Sunday, April 21st, when the Phillies play these St. Louis Cardinals at Veterans Stadium. Celebrate with the Fanatic plus mascots from around the country. All fans 14 and under receive an oversized beach towel featuring the Fanatic in a fun, colorful pose, compliments of Tasty Cake. Fanatic's birthday is Sunday, April 21st, 1:35. Order your tickets by phone by calling 463-1000 or stop by one of the many local Ticketmaster outlets. Ron Gant sends it to deep center field. Dykstra can't get it. Hit off the top of the fence, or did it go over the fence? It went over the fence. A home run for Ron Gant, his third.
How did Dykstra field that ball the way he fielded it if the ball went over the fence? I mean, did he take it off the... I don't know what he took it off of. Let's look at it.
They've got that flower bed out there over the center field fence. We mentioned that Gant has hurt Mulholland lifetime.
That's right. Exactly what happened just over that yellow line bounced back.
So the Cardinals lead it 1-0. Willie McGee fouls it off. Gant's third home run.
Couldn't have gone any further.
Well, it hit off the yellow line, it looks like.
Yeah, that's what it did.
It should be in play, shouldn't it? And it's got to go over the fence to be a home run.
Well, it must have. I can't tell you. It looked like it hit the top of that yellow line. It's got to go out of the ballpark. And he hit something, bounced up. Then he didn't say a word to anybody.
1-2 to Willie McGee. Gant should give the Cardinals a lot of power this summer. He hit 29 for Cincinnati last year. Willie McGee's down swinging. That's the second strikeout for Mulholland. One down here in the second. They bring up Gary Gaetti, the first baseman. Gaetti, another free agent, signed by St. Louis. Had a good year for Kansas City last year, hitting 261 and had a career-best 35 homers. One strike to Gaetti. It off his foot at the plate. No balls and two strikes to Gary Gaetti. That one stung as he limps back toward home plate.
It's hitting up there around the shin area and under the knee. Pretty sensitive area.
Ron Gant has put the Redbirds in front, 1-0 here in the second. Going two to Gaetti, who is still trying to shake it off. It to Gene Shaw at first. Shaw will make the unassisted put out. That's two down, and that'll bring on Pat Borders, the catcher.
Well, Holland seems to be throwing quite a few breaking balls, and they're pretty good ones. That slider he's low with, and I think he just got Gaetti on a changeup down and away. This guy's been hot.
Yep. Hitting 474. made the club as a non-roster invitee. Tom Pagnozzi on the disabled list. Pagnozzi probably will be ready to return next week. Borders has been hitting well. Borders hit the Phillies well in the World Series in 93. Hit 304 while catching for Toronto. Last year he played at Kansas City and Houston. Now down the third base side. Nothing and two to Pat Borders. Pass Terry Mulholland into center field for a base hit. Well, Borders a two-out base runner. That'll bring up David Bell. Bell came over to St. Louis last year in the deal that sent Ken Hill to Cleveland. Seventh round draft pick for Cleveland in the 90 draft. 23-year-old. Just 1-for-7 in the early going. Pops him up. Foul. Should be playable. Shaw has a lot of room. Makes the grab and that'll retire the side. St. Louis gets a run on a Gann homer. Two hits, no errors. They leave one. And at the end of two, 1-0 Cardinals.
Dodge Dakota is number one in resale versus Ford, Chevy, and GMC. Number one in horsepower. Number one in torque. Even number one in towing. In fact, Dodge Dakota is ranked number one in more categories versus any compact. So it should come as no surprise that across America, Dodge pickups are number one in sales growth. Now get up to $3,500 off on Dodge Dakota, including $1,000 cash back.
Introducing the Boston Carvers, the hot hand-carved sandwich from Boston Market. Hearth honey ham. Or double-sauced meatloaf Boston Carvers. Our famous chicken. Or rotisserie roasted turkey breast. Stacked high on a French or honey wheat roll. New Boston Carver sandwiches from Boston Market. Carving out a better sandwich.
I love you.
Oh, I love you too.
You see this flower?
Yeah.
Well, with the Cub Cadet tractors I sell, you'd never see something like this left standing. Now, it's got
a certain kind of person who's a Cub Cadet dealer.
You just lower the front of the mower deck about a quarter of an inch, and you'll suction everything up into this.
Who will help you pick the right equipment, then assemble, deliver, and maintain it.
Talk about the space shuttle, but does it have a direct drive shaft? Honey? Honey?
Introducing the Michelin X1 with a 6-year unlimited mileage tread life warranty. It gives you better wet traction than any rain tire. Plus control in any driving condition. After all, it hasn't rained that much in years.
Our first of five business person specials will be coming up April 23rd, 105 against Pittsburgh. Mellon PSFS business person special. Afternoon game starting at 105. Plan to be on hand. Order your tickets by calling 463-1000 or stop by Mellon PSFS at Broad and Chestnut Streets. Gene Shaw leads it off, hitting at 333. He has hit safely in all four starts since coming up from Scranton Wilkes-Barre. Fouls it back. No balls and two strikes to Shaw. This with a slider, 1-2. Shaw will be followed by Kevin Stocker, then Terry Mulholland. Two balls and two strikes. It's a foul. Still 2-2 to Shaw. First of four with St. Louis tomorrow night. Mike Williams goes against Tom Urbani. Saturday afternoon, Rich Hunter and Todd Stottlemyre. Sid Fernandez will pitch on Sunday. Brian Barber, young right-hander, will pitch for St. Louis. Full count. Is aboard. He becomes the Phillies' first base runner on the free ticket, and that'll bring up Kevin Stocker. Stock's been struggling at the plate, hitting at 0-50. 0 for his last 15. And when you're in an 0-for, this not a good pitcher to be facing. Stocker is hitless lifetime against Bennis, 0 for 13.
Well, he's due. He's due then.
Trying to bunt his way on, bunts a foul, one strike.
Looks like Stock has changed his style a little bit. He's choked up a little more on the bat. Swinging through a lot of pitches, and, you know, that will give him better bat control to choke up.
One and one to Kevin Stocker. Cardinals lead at 1-0. We're playing in the third. Ron Gant a home run. Center field, and that is a nice running catch by Willie McGee. Ball was in the gap, but Willie McGee just outran it. Still can run at age 37, one down.
Yeah, that's what happens when you're in a slump. They make a play like that on you. McGee was playing him shallow and right, as you can see, really shallow. Almost got away from him. Slipped in the grass.
Brings on Terry Mulholland. Mulholland will be up there to try to bunt the runner along, I would imagine. Lifetime an 080 hitter. No, he's swinging away and fouls it back. One strike to Terry Mulholland.
Almost bet he missed a sign.
Well, Larry Bowe is going to talk to Terry Mulholland.
You wouldn't want to know how many signs are missed in baseball. I know I missed plenty of them myself.
Now ball's in a strike to Terry Mulholland. Now he squares the bunt and takes it low, and it's one ball and one strike.
Well, as we're playing the Dodgers one year, the Brooklyn Dodgers, Campanella was the catcher. Everybody knew the Philly signs. It was so simple. Campanella knew them, and I missed a hit and run sign. I was the hitter, and Granny Hamner was the runner on first. He missed the sign. Twice in a row, we missed it. Campanella pitched out twice, and Campy says, "Don't you guys know your signs?" He got mad.
Mulholland bunts through the ball, one ball and two strikes. Strikes. First strikeout for Bennis. Two down here in the third. And that'll bring on Lenny Dykstra.
Center fielder Lenny Dykstra.
Well, we we found the Busch Stadium ground rules, Whitey, and it says ball hitting on or below yellow line is in play. Now, this ball hit on the yellow line.
Looks like it did, unless it hit something behind the, that
it
line.
It bounced straight up after it hit that yellow line. It did not sure leave the park.
I doubt if Lenny knows those ground rules. The players don't always know the ground rules.
Now, the ground rules say that in center field, if the ball hits the yellow line, it is in play.
And that was center field, about as center as you could get.
You got to hit it to left and right. It's got to be above the yellow line, and then it's a home run.
Kind of a nitpicky rule, and it seems like you ought to have a rule the same for all three fields. What if you hit it in left center? Is it apply to left field or center field?
It's got to go above the yellow. The only thing is the girders there, so it can hit above over the yellow line in left field and in right field, and you've got the support beams, and it can hit by a support beam and bounce back onto the field of play, but it still has to go over the yellow line for it to be a home run. Full count to Lenny Dykstra. Shaw at first base and two outs. Phillies didn't argue the call, and that has been the only run of the game, a homer by Ron Gant. Ground ball in the hole. Dennis gets over there in a hurry, and they just got Lenny Dykstra. Guy Eddie DeBattis, that'll retire the Phils. No runs, no hits, no errors, and one left. We go to the bottom half of the third inning. It's 1-0 St. Louis.
What will you do with the money you save at Speedy?
I saved $49 on my Honda's brakes, so I got my husband surfing lessons.
I saved $44 on my brake job over the dealer, and I'm keeping it.
Right now, get 20% off all brake parts at Speedy.
I saved $53 on my minivan's brakes. I guess I got number 99 here, skating lessons.
And at Speedy, you never need an appointment. Speedy for brakes, Speedy for savings. Guaranteed.
Athlete's foot. It's a predator made up of many types of fungus that eat your feet alive. You can't just cure some of them. You need a weapon to kill all of them. Lotrimin AF, full prescription strength medicine, the brand doctors recommend most. Lotrimin AF is so powerful, it doesn't just kill some causes, it kills them all. Also available in spray and powder. Lotrimin AF, the killer cure.
It's fast. It's convenient. It's courteous. It's easy. It's simple. It's hassle-free. It's practical. It's helpful. It's handy. It's the way thousands of smart people get their tickets to Phillies games. They just call 463-1000 to find out which seats are available. It's time to order tickets to any Phillies home game. Just call 463-1000.
Join Bo Luzinski, Cash Allen, and many other Phillies stars at Phillies Dream Week next February in Clearwater. One full week to live, learn, and play with the pros like Larry Anderson, Von Hayes, Bob Grenier, Jim Fregosi. Don't delay, though. The roster spots fill up quickly. Call 215-938-1200. Dream Week in Florida in February. Great time to be down there. Call 215-938-1200. Andy Bennis leads it off. Dennis 1-for-4. He'll take his hacks. He's a 127 lifetime hitter. He has hit 4 career home runs.
Well, he swings hard, and he's big and strong, so if he ever hits one, it'll go.
beats that ball foul. One and two to Bennis. Tried to check, he committed. Strikeout throw out for out number one. Third strikeout for Bo Holland.
Santiago made a pretty good play on that ball down the inside there and in the dirt. Watch him scooch his body over there.
Boy, he is excellent at blocking low pitches.
Yeah, really is.
Talking to some of the pitchers on the flight from Pittsburgh yesterday, and they love Benito. They say we're not afraid to throw our breaking ball, curve ball, bounce it up there. We know Santiago will have it blocked. Liberty Bell College Baseball Classic at Veterans Stadium. This is the second day. Yesterday, Drexel edged LaSalle 6-5 and Temple beat Rider 6-4. Today's game, Delaware beat Penn 14-4, and Villanova is currently playing St. Joe's.
Delaware won it last year. Having another pretty good team. I went to a dinner with a LaSalle baseball team this winter.
Gene Shaw will make that play. Alisea is retired for out number two. Phillies Farm Department, Scranton Wilkes-Barre. That game was played in 23 degree wind chill. There are a lot of errors. Syracuse won that one by a score of 5-3. Harrisburg edged Reading despite Matt Peach's great outing. He pitched six innings and struck out a dozen. The left-hander for Reading. And Brevard County defeated Clearwater 6-3.
LaSalle lost their game yesterday when Drexel scored, I think, five runs. Beat him 6-5 in the ninth or tenth inning.
One and one here to Royce Clayton. Clayton, a base hit up the middle. Cardinals' third hit off Terry Mulholland, and Clayton is one of the guys that might try to steal a base. As we mentioned, they're not the running Redbirds, but Clayton leads them in steals with three.
That slider, Mulholland left, right, over the middle of plate.
Here's Ray Langford. He flied out to left field his first time up.
Not many people try to steal on Mulholland.
No, he's very hard to run on.
Keeps him close.
Great step off pickoff move. One and nothing to Ray Langford.
Clayton's not taking much of a lead.
No.
Get out there too far, Mulholland will pick you off.
Doing nothing to Ray Langford. Miles are back and out of play. 2-1. Lead 1-0 on the home run by Ron Gant. takes it hard to the opposite field, but Eisenreich puts it away in front of the warning track. No runs, one hit, no errors, one left. Chris Wheeler joins Rich Ashford in the fourth after 3-1-0 St. Louis.
Before you buy that new Ford Explorer, let's compare it to this Chevy Blazer. Come with me.
You'll find Blazer offers the largest displacement V6 in any truck, standard. And right now, a special factory offer means you could drive a new Blazer for only $299 a month. That's right, lease a 96 Blazer with four-wheel drive, four doors, air conditioning, stereo, and more, all for just $299 a month. What are you waiting for?
See your Chevy Geo dealers today.
I never imagined our dream house would need so much work.
The difference between the dream and the house...
This is the problem.
...are all those trips to the hardware store.
Perfect paint for you. It's called Easy Living. It's
introducing the Sears Hardware Store with everything you need and need to know. All at great Sears prices.
It has two speeds, comes with two battery packs.
This is our dream house, but it's going to take some work.
Sears Hardware Stores. Now there's a craftsman right in the neighborhood.
He travels for days to the farthest reaches of South America. He carefully selects only the finest beans. And after they're roasted to perfection, only then will you hear him say,
"Time to make the coffee."
Dunkin' Donuts coffee, brewed fresh all day long. Now you can get fresh brewed coffee and a freshly baked cinnamon bun for a great price.
Travel provided by U.S. Air. U.S. Air offers the only daily nonstop service between Philadelphia and Frankfurt, Germany.
Phil's bat here in the fourth. Mickey Morandini leads it off. Grounded out his first time up. Phil's still looking for their first base hit. Up Andy Bennis. Ball one to Morandini. Morandini, Eisenreich, and Zeal. First three batters here in the fourth. Chris Wheeler has joined us. It's a good pitch.
Mickey and Andy Bennis go back a long way. They played on the U.S. Olympic baseball team back in 1988. Mickey out of Indiana.
Fouls it off. A belated birthday for Linda Albertson in Stroudsburg. Happy birthday to Linda. Ripped. Off the wall. Morandini's going to get two out of it. Hit right off the bottom of the fence, the first Phillies hit, a Morandini double.
Well, Mickey's had good lifetime numbers against his old Olympic teammate, and he nails this one. Willie McGee made a great play earlier, but he can't get to this ball as he hit it over his head. Here you see the pitch from Andy Bennis out over the plate and over Willie McGee's head and off the padding of that wall. No doubt that that one was not off the yellow line, at least. That was a little controversial, that first one, but... You know, I guess nobody could see it, and it took a lot of replays for us to figure it out, too.
Eisenreich, the batter, flied out to left. Owen inside for a ball. Eisenreich is hitting at 385.
And Mickey now has 12 lifetime hits off Andy Bennis.
Goes trail here, 1-0, the top of the fourth. Fouled off. Ball and a strike to Eisenreich. Big Andy Bennis. Fouled back.
Bennis is really staying away from him in this at bat, trying to prevent Eisenreich from pulling the ball and getting Morandini over to third. And he's ahead in the count now, so he can play around out there a little bit more. Here's where Gossi looks on from those new dugouts. This place is really different here.
Left field. This won't move the runner. on Gant will put it away.
He never did get it done there, and Andy Benes just kept staying away from Jim Eisenreich, that hole at bat, and Eisenreich just never could get a ball he could pull.
Philly season tickets come in all sizes, from full season to 13 Sundays and 16 game plans, and they may be just your ticket to the All-Star Game. Find out which season ticket plans guarantee All-Star Game tickets. Call the sales office at 463-5000. Here's Zeal. Base hit. Morandini's going to score easy enough. Zeal will hold with a long single, and we're tied at 1-1. Todd Zeal getting an RBI, his fourth.
Gant got to that ball quickly, too. He was playing Zeal to pull, and now with this grass and dirt here, the balls aren't going to get to the corners as fast as they used to. Here you see a first ball fastball in a little bit, and he hits it right down the line, and Gant, you'll come into the picture really fast. Here comes Ron Gant. And see how the ball slows up now, and Gant gets it back in, holds him to a single, keeps a double play in order.
Says Whitten grounded out his first time up.
This will be a different game they're going to play here in Busch Stadium now, with grass and dirt, without that AstroTurf and without the tartan turf warning tracks, where the balls would scoot so much faster, and you won't get ground rule doubles probably as much bouncing over the walls.
Deal on first, one out. Ball one to Whitten. Might be a double play. That retires the side, but the Phillies tie the game. One run, two hits, and nobody left on. Cards bat in the fourth. We're tied 1-1.
I know he just wants what's best for me, but Daddy's always been overprotective.
If my daughter sheds one more tear because of something you've done, I will break every single bone in your body.
Yet he never took the time to really understand what I was going through. After all, I'm the one who became a bride and a widow in the same week. And now I've learned that no one can protect me from life. Not even Edward Burton.
Savannah, the first episode.
Sunday at 9 on WB 17.
Vacation Center at 1-800-4-LETS-GO.
Hello, I'm meteorologist Larry Cosgrove. Coming up in Inquirer News tonight, some good news for a change. We have high pressure building in from Virginia and West Virginia. That means fair and warmer weather. But how long can it last? We also have to examine the storm out west, how it may progress into Philadelphia by the weekend. We'll talk about that weekend in great detail after the Phillies game here on WB 17 Inquirer News tonight. Be there.
Tonight's game is brought to you by the Pennsylvania Lottery. Lottery proceeds benefit older Pennsylvanians. By Pico Energy, focusing our energies on you. And your local Dodge dealers, come in today because we know how to help. Ron Gant counted for the Cardinals run with a controversial. It wasn't so controversial. It was a home run, but nobody argued it. Strike one on Gant. Got him on an off-speed pitch. Strike two. One-one tie, bottom of the fourth. First of a four-game series here in St. Louis. Oh, ripped to right field. Higher on Gant. Ooh. Whitten had trouble picking it up. Gant with a opposite field double. Well, when he gets hot, he can hurt you.
Well, he's a great signing by the Cardinals. You know, the guy proved last year he's back and healthy. Here he goes 0-2 the other way. You know, for the most part, he's going to try and pull balls. But he got behind in the count, and he just got a pitch away from him, hit it down the line, fair for a double.
Like Terry got the ball up and away. Can't even look to be fooled on it a little bit, but he got good wood on the ball.
Well, ideally, he was trying to sink a ball away from him.
Willie McGee struck out his first time up. Hitting at 250.
Willie McGee wants Tommy Reynolds to go through the signs again down there at third base to see whether or not he would bunt in this situation. McGee's always been good, even as a right-handed batter hitting the ball to the right side. Left-handed, he was good at pulling it. So you think he'd be on his own here. Tony La Russa is a little bit unorthodox, so you never know.
Hit it the other way to Morandini and got the runner over to third.
Yeah, McGee's good at that. I mean, you see how long he waited on that pitch and then just hit it to the right side. It's always been a strong point in his game to be able to do those kind of things. Take a look. Righty's hit a controversial home run. It was really hard to tell when this ball was hit by the naked eye, but when you see it on here, you can see it hits right in the middle of the yellow line and then bounces back into play. As Dykstra leaps here, can't get it, right there on the yellow line, and this ball is in play at that point. And Gant wound up at second, then they waved him on for a home run, which it wasn't.
Ripped to right. Went in good play, and we're going to have a play at home. Got away. Got away from Santiago. Gant scores, and the Cardinals lead it 2-1.
There is the difference between making a throw on turf and a throw on grass and dirt. Right there. Witten makes that throw in the old field here. Boom, it's a one-hopper right to Santiago, and the guy's out at the plate. Here on grass and dirt, they're not going to take as true a hop, obviously. Witten makes a strong throw, but watch the ball skid. One hop, second hop, it skids right there. Santiago tries to catch it and block the plate, and he never catches it.
I think he'd have been out, too, if
yep.
he could have held on to the ball.
Sure. That's a difference in playing on the surface now.
Cardinals lead it 2-1, an RBI for Gaetti. Pat Border singled his first time up. Strike one on Border.
I think Witten forgot a little bit. You know, he got off balance and he had a lunge to his left. But I think he forgot a little bit about the surface because he knows the old days that one hopper was only going to take one hop, right? He wasn't going to take two hops.
It hugged the ground.
Sure.
Ball and two strikes on Border. Right field, and Witten pulls it in. That'll retire the side, but a run on one hit and nobody left on base. After four full innings, we're tied 1-1.
Time. You never seem to have enough of it. Gotta go here, gotta be there. So when do you have time to bank? Midnight? Sunday morning? Why not? At Mellon,
thank you for calling.
We offer 24-hour telephone banking services, hundreds of ATMs, full-service offices, plus many Acme Market offices open 7 days a week. Sound convenient? Call 1-800-MELLON-24 and find out how you can bank where you want, when you want. Mellon PSFS.
When your car's brakes need repair, simply replacing a part makes no more sense than tuning one key on a piano. The whole system needs to work together. That's why Midas always begins a brake job with a complete system inspection. That way, the job's done right. And that's music to the ears.
Right now, at participating Midas Auto Systems Expert stores, you'll get 25% off brake shoes and pads. Guaranteed for as long as you own your car.
Midas Auto Systems Experts. What can we do for you today?
It's been said that everyone will be famous for 15 minutes. For some, that's just their daily commute. The Lexus Coupe.
Let's take a look at how they scored. Good ball game so far tonight. Good pitching. Gant's controversial home run, 1-0. Then the Phillies tied it on Zeal's RBI single, and then you just saw Gary Gaetti after the double by Gant with a sacrifice fly. 2-1 St. Louis moving to the fifth in a well-played, well-pitched ball game here at Busch Stadium.
Santiago leads it off. Fly to center, his first time up. Santiago, Shaw, and Stocker. Strike.
Danny Bennis has developed a little different delivery this year. Not as wind up as much as the way he takes the sign.
Crouch.
Yeah, it's very different. But it's funny, once he gets going, you know, once his arms get going, you know, he looks like Andy Bennis again. But at the start, he never used to do this. Now, for whatever reason, he crouches a little bit. He puts one foot on the rubber, the back foot, and the other foot in front of the rubber, which he did not take the sign that way before.
Pat him on a curveball, looked like, or a slow slider. It's his second strikeout for Bennis.
Bennis has pitched two real good ball games for the Cardinals to no decisions. Here is Whitey says he gets him on a breaking ball there.
Gene Shaw walked first time up. A lot of strikes being thrown by both pitchers. Strike one on Shaw.
Well, they always talk about speeding the game up. How do you speed it up?
Throw strikes.
There it is. Maddox and Ashby today, 2 hours and 2 minutes at San Diego. 2-1 ball game.
2-1 on Shaw. And center best along to Joe Kernan, Wynwood, PA, recovering from abdominal surgery. He went after a bad pitch there.
And he swung fastball all the way, and he got a 2-1 breaking ball.
I've been wondering why hitters don't wait a little longer and see what the pitch is. Not what they think it's going to be, but what it is. Now hold the 2-2.
Now here's the play, that the sacrifice fly to Mark Whitten, and it looks like he catches it off to the side. See, he misjudged it a little bit. Now he's got to reach down, and that gets him a little out of whack when he goes to throw, cost him precious time, and then the two-hop throw, the run score. That ball sunk on him, and he misjudged it a little bit.
Full count to Shaw. Ball into the crowd. Also send our best along to Eddie Sawyer once again, Phillies former manager who broke a hip in Phoenixville Hospital.
Eddie's still in Valley Forge?
Valley Forge Mountain.
Right.
In Poly. Fouled again.
I've heard you say he's the best manager you ever played for.
Well, no question. Yeah. I played for him in the minor leagues and the major leagues. He broke a hip making a bed. A hazardous occupation, I guess.
A lot of men have considered that their whole lives. Still do.
Got him on that 3-2 slider.
Bennis is pitching backwards more than we've ever seen him. Andy Bennis has always been a guy you thought of as a National League power pitcher. 2-1 breaking ball in this count. Now a 3-2 breaking ball there to Shaw, and absolutely locked him on it. This is a different style of pitcher that we're used to seeing in Andy Bennis.
Well, they were catching up to his fastball.
Right.
You know, he was getting hurt.
Right. He would challenge hitters in that situation. Now he's not doing it as much.
Stocker the batter. He was robbed of a base hit his last time up on a fine play by right fielder Willie McGee.
Ball one. Hit no 50 the way that he was, and added that. Then you hit one like that, that's what happens.
One and one to count. Remember that 0 for 32 I had? I hit a solid base hit to right. A pitcher was on first, and he got thrown out at second. Maybe John Quinn was right when he said to me one time, trouble to you, you don't hit your singles far enough.
Sure, hit that one hopper, right? Right in front of the guy. Yeah, but if you hit it further, it's an out.
It's an out. Correct. A ball and two strikes on Stocker. That's Dave Duncan. That's he was La Russa's pitching coach in Oakland for years.
And he's a catcher. Former catcher.
Struck him out, and that retires the side, and Bennis strikes out the side. Cardinals bat in the fifth. They lead 2-1.
Recently, the camera shop went all blue by offering their employees health plans from Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
Our employees and their families think the coverage is great, and so do I.
They've got a great selection of doctors.
There's no paperwork at all. I can call in customer service, and they give me an answer right away.
It's a local company, and I like that.
Great service, no hassles.
Go all blue with personal choice, Keystone HMO, or our traditional plan from Independence Blue Cross and Pennsylvania Blue Shield. The folks you can lean on.
Less pollution.
More training. More pedaling.
Less pollution.
More sweat. More hills.
Less pollution.
More sore thighs.
Who's reducing air pollutants by over 3 million tons a year and donating natural gas vehicles to the Olympics? PICO Energy, proud member of the American Gas Association's Clean Air Team, official sponsor of the 1996 Olympics.
At Michelin, we believe a tire that's just good in the rain isn't good enough. Introducing the Michelin X1. With a 6-year, unlimited mileage tread life warranty. It's the one tire that gives you better wet traction than any rain tire, plus control in any driving condition. After all, it hasn't rained that much in years. The Michelin X1.
Cardinals will be in Philadelphia April 19th, 20th, and 21st. It's a Friday night at 7:35, Saturday at 7:05. The Sunday game is 1:35, and it's Tasty Cake Fanatic's birthday. The Cardinals in that weekend. This is David Bell, who popped out his first time up, fouled out. Pirates will come in next that Monday and Tuesday, both. Or the Monday game is 7:35 starting. The Tuesday game is the business person special. Mellon PSFS business person special. For tickets, call 463-1000. Ball and a strike to Bell. Bell, Bennis, Alisea facing Mulholland here in the fifth. 2-1 the count. Well, you don't know how to play in this warm weather, I don't think. Should be an easy play for Dykstra, and is.
It's kind of nice, isn't it, to sit here as pleasant as it is this evening.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the Phillies and may not be reproduced or retransmitted without the express written consent of the Phillies and WPHL-TV. Andy Bennis, the pitcher. Strike one.
We have to treat him with some respect. They just moved Dykstra over to right center. He's deep. Now Witten is cheating way in right field. On Venice. This guy can bomb once in a while.
Dykstra. There's a beat on it. He didn't hit that one too badly.
No, he has four lifetime home runs, two of them off the Phillies, including his first major league homer.
Two outs and the leadoff hitter, Luis Alisea. Was lined out and grounded out. It's just about 50 degrees too warm here.
It is nice.
80 degrees at the start of the game. A strike on Ali Sayed.
Let's get a little cooler as the week end goes along, but tonight is just perfect. Don't ever remember being in a game here where the flags are blowing the way they are, unless there's a storm coming. And there isn't any storm coming tonight. Look at those flags straight out. And that's unusual for St. Louis.
Swung in a high pitch. I do not smell rain, although rain is coming this weekend.
That's Brian Jordan right there. Arizona disabled us with a sore thumb, and they miss him. Yeah, this is the spot of your infamous rain smell.
That's right. It rained for 2 months. Flooded the whole Mississippi Valley. Missouri Valley.
Well, they do not want to hear you talk that way again.
They didn't believe me when I said it smell rain. Hey, I'm a corn husker. You know, you can smell rain.
2 months of it, huh?
Full count on Ali Sayed. Two outs, nobody on. And a base hit between Zeal and Stocker. Didn't seem to hit it very hard, but it got through there.
No, it's funny. See, they're playing him to pull with Zeal, but up the middle was Stocker. So when the ball goes to the left, look at see how far Stocker had to come for it. He had no chance. And the ball was hit far to Zeal's left, and he couldn't get to it. He didn't hit it very hard.
Clayton the batter, one for two with a single. Ball one to Clayton. The shortstop right now with Ozzie Smith on the disabled list.
Right, and they brought a young player up today, an infielder named Aaron Holbert, who is available to play the infield as a backup player for them, a middle infielder.
Ball on the strike on the plate.
David Bell can play second base. In fact, that's where he's probably better suited, but they're playing both Bell and Gaetti tonight with a left-hander.
And a miss. Well, Holland's making some pretty good pitches in this game. He's behind 2-1. The Phillies are certainly within striking distance. Struck him out. Good fastball. No runs, a hit, one left on after five full innings. Cardinals lead the Phillies 2-1.
Cleaner. It's self-propelled, forward and back, with reversible drive wheels and fingertip control. The self-propelled Hoover Power Drive. It makes the cleaning so effortless, you might say it's child's play.
Hoover, nobody does it like you.
It's the furniture event to shatter all others. Emergency furniture liquidation. Final days. Diamond Furniture must make room. After buying out the entire stock of Moore's Furniture, we are forced to liquidate now. We must make room for new truckloads arriving daily. Nothing held back. Take advantage of extreme liquidation prices. Get immediate delivery or take it with you today. Excess furniture at shattered prices. Final days. Hurry into the Diamond Furniture outlet nearest you now.
After five, good ball games so far. Great pitching by Andy Bennis and Terry Mulholland. And there you see Mulholland giving up the two runs, one for Bennis. It's about even. Strikeouts are even. And only one walk in the ball game as it's been a rapidly played five innings. We've only played about, maybe an hour and 15 minutes.
Mark Sweeney is playing first now for the Cardinals. Caetti's out of the game with an injured leg, I think, the foul ball. Popped off his leg.
They said it went on. There's Sweeney, the first baseman. They said he injured a toe, and preliminary x-rays were negative.
Two strikes on Mulholland. Mulholland, Dykstra, and Morandini. First three hitters. In the sixth. 1-2 the count. That Shaw got the only walk off of Venice of the ball game. Joe called him out, but pretty outside. Didn't give a pitcher a break.
Center fielder, Lenny.
Well, you always looked at it. Mulholland does a smart thing. Took a look around, like, was that really a strike? And then walked away because he wants that pitch.
Yeah. It's five straight strikeouts, or four straight strikeouts. Well, Venice, here's Dykstra. 0-2. Takes a strike.
Venice is doing a good job of starting hitters with a strike tonight and getting ahead of hitters. Andy Venice used to just fire. I mean, he had that hard high rider and a hard breaking ball. And now he is a very different pitcher that we're seeing tonight. He's a pitcher using his stuff really well.
2-1 on Dykstra. He's a 6'6" guy trying to pitch like a 5'6" pitcher.
Well, he's not old. I mean, he's only 28 years of age, but it's obvious he does not have the fastball, consistent fastball that he used to have. There he goes again, throwing a breaking ball behind in the count. And that was never Andy Venice, and that's the way he's pitching tonight. He's pitching backwards to a lot of these hitters.
3-1 the count to Dykstra. Hit it in the air, not very far. Langford coming in, shallow center. Had a good pitch to hit there. Not under it. Two outs, and Morandini, who is 1-for-2 with a double and has scored the Phillies run. Hitting 300 right on the nose now.
Mickey's up among the league leader in doubles.
Left field side, and Gant can't get it back into the crowd. Strike on Morandini. He really looks like he wants to have a good season. He's out of the chute strong and stealing some bases, fielding gold glove type fielding.
Phillies have only made two errors this year, the lowest amount in the league. One is by Mickey. It was on a line drive that he misplayed. The other was on a throw by Witten in the middle of the diamond that got away. So they didn't play real well defensively in spring training, but they played pretty well since the season started.
Ball and a strike on Morandini. Two outs, nobody on. Low. Close, but outside. 3-1 to Morandini.
Hot dog wrapper blowing across the infield. Venice has distracted him. Now Sweeney's going to come in and get it.
How could they dare throw that hot dog wrapper out on the field and distract that poor fella?
It's a windy night.
Walks him, a two-out walk. Second walk given up by Venice.
Left fielder.
Now, Whitey, you mentioned that Mickey's been running 5 out of 5 so far. And Bennis takes a while to get the ball to the plate. Great time to steal a base if you can to get in the scoring position with 2 outs for a guy like Eisenreich, who hits a lot of singles.
Izzy's 0 for 2, twice flying out to left.
Bennis is aware of that. You see Bennis, you know, that way he's in the stretch is different than we're used to seeing him, too, where he's kind of hunkered over, trying to keep runners on a little bit better. Someone's been working with him. He used to be able to run on him.
I'm in the new pitching coach he has here.
Possibly. I mean, a 6'6" pitcher, you could run off. You know, it's hard for, and he, as I mentioned, was such a power pitcher with a big leg kick. He's very much aware of the fact of what we just talking about. This is a good time for Morandini to run.
Easy play, Andy Bennis, and that'll retire the side. No runs, no hits, one left on. Cardinals bat in the sixth. They lead the Phillies 2-1.
Hey, boss.
Bob. Gentlemen.
Frankie.
Hi, fellas.
Hi, Lee. Do they really think they can pass as him?
No. People know the genuine article when they see it, like the genuine Bellomanic elevators. It has the information and choices that make shopping easier. 9 out of 10 use it. The genuine Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages.
Hey, boys, lost my way to Vegas.
Bell Atlantic, the heart of communication.
It's him!
It's spring, and deals are springing up at your Toyota dealer.
How about a great lease deal on Corolla, a benchmark of quality for 28 years? Only $189 a month, with air conditioning, power steering, and dual airbags. Or take a look at Tercel, Toyota's lowest-priced sedan, and see what a savings you'll get. Big deals, great savings, low financing.
Get to your Toyota dealer fast, because summer's just around the corner.
I love you.
Oh, I love you, too.
You see this flower?
Yeah.
Well, with the Cub Cadet tractors I sell, you'd never see something like this left standing. No, it's got
a... It's a certain kind of person who's a Cub Cadet dealer.
You just lower the front of the mower deck, about 1/4 inch, and you'll suction everything up into this...
Who will help you pick the right equipment, then assemble, deliver, and maintain it.
Talk about the space shuttle, but does it have a direct drive shaft? Honey? Honey!
Tonight's game is brought to you by Budweiser, official sponsor of the 1996 U.S. Olympic team. This Bud's for you. The Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages, the book 9 out of 10 people use and keep and count on. And nobody gets a dirt like Hoover. Nobody. Ray Lankford leads off in the bottom of the sixth against Mo Holland. Ball one on Langford. He has flied out to left, lined out to left. Langford, Gant, McGee. Ball is easy play for, well, not so easy. The wind must have picked it up. Eisenreich stays with it. Three times now that Langford has flied out to Eisenreich. Here's a guy that's hurt. Mulholland is Ron Gant with a home run and a double, and he scored both runs.
Shouldn't be a surprise because he came into the game with 4 homers, 8 RBIs off him. Lifetime 353 hitter.
He is strong. Inside corner for a strike. This guy's arms are like a blacksmith's arm. Arm wrestle this fella. Whips that ball. 3 for 3 is Ron Gant.
Yeah, 2 times he's gone the other way, too. The center field ball called a home run that wasn't, and 2 balls hit hard to right field, 1 for a double, and there that base hit.
Yeah, that single was scorched, too.
Sure, he's hit it hard all 3 times tonight. Pitches away from him again. Mulholland's trying to throw him a sinker down and away, and he threw the ball belt high, or maybe even a little bit up more than that, and Gant just went with it.
He's a one-out base runner. Willie McGee, who is 0 for 2.
Gant used to really be able to run. He was a base stealer at one time before he broke that leg. Of course, hardly anybody's a base stealer against Mo Howell. Mulholland and Santiago could be one of the great combinations of keeping runners at first base.
Yeah, he keeps them, Mulholland keeps them close, and Santiago throws them out. Sometimes from his knees. Fouled away, ball and a strike to Willie McGee.
He really pulled Gant that time. Gant's just kind of shaking his head. Mulholland gave that little quick leg kick he gives, and then comes to home plate. So even when he doesn't move over there, he fools the base runners with his leg actions.
Right field base hit. Whitten will make the play in, and good at bat there by Willie McGee.
Yeah, you have to give them both credit. Both those hitters, because they both took balls away to right field, as opposed to trying to pull them and ground out to the shortstop or third baseman. Mulholland trying to go away from McGee, same thing, got too much of the plate and up a little more than he wanted it.
There's Mark Sweeney, who came in the game for Gaetti.
Well, this is a break. See what happens. I mean, on paper, you would think this is a break for Mulholland to get a left-handed batter Sweeney in this spot, as opposed to a power hitter like Gaetti from the right side.
Infield, a double play depth, left-hander to left-hander. That'd be a double play. There's one, and there is two. Perfect one hopper back to Mulholland. That'll retire the side. No runs, two hits, one left on. Harry Callis joins Wheels in the seventh after six full. Cardinals lead the Phillies 2-1.
We got a player.
I'd like the lottery ticket.
Yeah, she is a player. She's a big player.
I'll say, straight.
You're nuts. Straight and backs it up with a pair.
428 and boxes.
Oh, she's a boxer.
Ding, 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 ding.
Bring it. All right. Adrian, you know her? No, I don't know her, Ed. I was making a literary reference.
Pennsylvania Lottery's daily number. Play a pair, box, or play it straight.
When we broke our first sales record, we were pleased. The second and third, very pleased indeed. The fourth, we were motivated. So during the Dodge Best Buy Celebration, we're pleased to offer this Best Buy, Dodge Intrepid. Standard, it's got more passenger room, power, and equipment than Ford Taurus. And now with up to $1,500 cash savings, this Best Buy simply can't get any better. See the friendly Dodge dealer near you.
Celebrate the Fanatics' birthday with zany mascots from around the country. Fans 14 and under receive a colorful Fanatic beach towel. Compliments of Tasty Cake when the Phillies play the Cardinals Sunday, April 21st at 1:35. Call 463-1000.
After six innings of play, it's the Cardinals 2 and the Phillies 1. Sunday at 8:30, Kirk medals in Elizabeth's love life on Kirk, only on WB 17, the home of the WB television network. Good ball game. Andy Bennis, Terry Mulholland, Todd Zeal, who owes the only RBI for the Phillies tonight, leads it off here in the seventh. For play-by-play, here's Harry.
All right, thanks, Wheels. Zeal, one of the two hits given up by Bennis, the other a double by Mickey Morandini. One ball and no strikes to Todd Zeal.
play with it every day.
What about all today?
One and one.
Andy Bennett does not want his little brother to outshine him, I guess. He's pitching a heck of a game.
Alan Bennis yesterday struck out 11 expos in winning 4-1. And he always seems to pitch well against the Phillies. Witness, there's Alan. Witness his lifetime record against the Phillies. 9-3 coming into this game. More wins against the Phillies than any other team.
And as we've noted tonight, he's a very different pitcher, is Andy Bennis, than the pitcher we've seen before. He is nowhere near the power pitcher he used to be.
Zeal helps him there, chasing the high pitch, a full count to Todd Zeal.
He got himself into a fastball situation, he thought, and he got it, but it was way out of the strike zone.
Taps it softly to third base, charged by Bell, gets Zeal for out number one.
3-2 slider from Andy Bennis, and all night tonight he has been doing that, throwing breaking balls in these situations. And here's Todd Zeal, jumps way out in front of a slider, swinging fastball, hits it right off the end of the bat, and Bell charges and makes a good play. But I don't ever remember seeing Andy Bennis throw breaking balls in these situations as much as he has in this ballgame.
Here's Mark Whitney, is grounded out and grounded into a double play. One and nothing to Whitten. As good as Bennis has looked over the years against the Phillies, it's hard to believe that this pitcher is lifetime one game under 500. In the major leagues, he is 76 and 77 lifetime.
Two no decisions this year, even though he's pitched well. So all three starts for the Cardinals, he's pitched well.
Whitten goes down swinging. That'll be six strikeouts for Bennis. Two down here in the seventh.
Mark Whitten appeared to chase a breaking ball here. And another example of Andy Bennis going for an out with an off-speed pitch. That was a changeup. And he got him to jump at it.
Here's Santiago. He has flied to center and struck out. Well, that one out of play. On strike to Benito Santiago. First and four with the Cardinals. We'll be televising all of them for you here on WB17. Mike Williams against Tom Urbani tomorrow night. Saturday's a day game. Rich Hunter and Todd Stadelmeyer. And Sunday a day game. Sid Fernandez against rookie Brian Barber. One ball and two strikes.
They have David Bell, the third baseman, well over near the line, playing Santiago to pull here late in the ball game in a one-run game. And you see where the third baseman is. He's over further than he was in Benito's earlier at bat. Real cat and mouse game with these two, because as we mentioned earlier, Santiago's really good lifetime numbers off Bennis. Santiago caught him, so he's trying to get in his head. But this is a different pitcher than he caught.
Santiago is called out on strikes, and that's seven strikeouts for Bennis. No runs, hits, errors, and none left. Stretch time at Busch Stadium. We go to the bottom of the seventh. St. Louis leading the Phillies 2-1.
When America thinks of comedy, America thinks of Michigan J.
That's me.
Where you'll find Wednesday family fun that can't be beat.
Okay.
Starting with a sister-sister double switcheroo.
Tonight you're not you, you're me, so stay away from me and don't be you.
Then on Parenthood, Nicholas has a new teacher.
You know this guy?
Oh, yeah. He's our rep house more than I am.
And on the way in, Pops is losing his touch.
With some dirty dishes in a soup.
What did I put the dishwasher?
This soup is slim.
Saturday at 8 on WB17.
Life's adventures can take you anywhere, and it's so much easier to get there in a Ford Explorer with switch-on all-wheel drive. It's the top-selling sport utility with standard dual airbags, as well as the roomiest interior. Plus, Explorer has the highest quality of any compact sport utility.
Your Ford dealers.
the diamond one.
The new Ford Explorer. Far and away the best the world has to offer.
Buying a new wet dry vac? Remember, only one has two separate tanks. One for wet, one for dry. So it never leaves a mess in the tank.
Nobody does it like you.
Introducing the Michelin X1. With a 6-year unlimited mileage tread life warranty. It gives you better wet traction than any rain tire. Plus control in any driving condition. After all, it hasn't rained that much in years.
Can you name the number one cause of death for people under age 44? For this age group, traffic accidents are the number one cause of death. The good news is that seatbelts have saved over 25,000 lives in the past 10 years. So be sure to buckle up.
Chevrolet Game Summer is going to show you two guys the difference in this one. For the St. Louis Cardinals, Ron Gant, 3-for-3 with a home run and the double. Andy Bennis, 7 strong innings. Terry Mulholland pitched great for the Phillies tonight. And Todd Zeal with one of the two hits for the Phillies and the only run batted in as we go to the bottom of the 7th.
Andy Bennis has the Phillies stifled through the first 7 on a couple of hits and a run, leading it 2-1 as Pat Borders leads it off. Borders has singled and flied out to right field. Mulholland's last inning. He is scheduled to hit 3rd in the 8th inning.
Kind of seems funny to see the pitchers not warm up on the field here at Busch Stadium, where those bullpens are located now out in left field.
We've done a lot with this ballpark. And on the right side to Morandini. Borders retired, 1 down. That'll bring up David Bell.
Well, they have an open-air bullpen, do the Cardinals. The Phillies are down the left field line to the right of the 330 there. And you see the Phillies bullpen, and then panning around where the Cardinals are, they took some of those bleachers out and put a bullpen. Next year, they're going to do the same thing in right field, take bleachers out there, put the other bullpen in right center.
One of nothing to Bell. He is fouled out to Gene Shaw and flied out to center field. A little bit high, 2 balls and no strikes.
The second 3 generations, the Bells after the Boones.
Yep. Fly ball center field. Lenny Dykstra has a bead on it. Dude puts it away for out number 2, and that will bring up Andy Bennis. Bennis has struck out and flied out to deep center. He drew one to him. He can hit it out of the ballpark. He's hit 4 career homers.
We've seen 2 of them.
Well, Dennis Cook, 1.
Right, that was the first one.
Hit the shortstop. Kevin Stocker takes care of Bennis in an easy 1-2-3 inning for Mulholland here in the 7th. No runs, hits, errors, and none left. We go to the 8th inning, 2-1, Cardinals.
I just got a promotion and a cellular phone. My little brother got one, too.
Nothing of competitive.
I got the big calling plan.
I got a local plan. My job's more focused.
At Bell Atlantic 9X Mobile, cellular service isn't one size fits all. From phone features to calling plans, you get services that fit your life.
I also got voicemail.
You did?
I want that.
Bell Atlantic 9X Mobile.
Introducing the Boston Carvers, the hot hand-carved sandwich from Boston Market. Hearth honey ham. Or double-sauced meatloaf Boston Carvers. Our famous chicken. Or rotisserie roasted turkey breast. Stacked high on a French or honey wheat roll. New Boston Carver sandwiches from Boston Market. Carving out a better sandwich.
Before you buy that new Ford Explorer, let's compare it to this Chevy Blazer. Come with me.
you'll find Blazer offers the largest displacement V6 in any truck, standard. And right now, a special factory offer means you could drive a new Blazer for only $299 a month. That's right, lease a 96 Blazer with four-wheel drive, four doors, air conditioning, stereo, and more, all for just $299 a month. What are you waiting for?
See your Chevy Geo dealers today.
Tonight's game is brought to you by Budweiser, official sponsor of the 1996 U.S. Olympic team. This Bud's for you. By Bell Atlantic 9X Mobile, now offering great rates on cellular long distance. And by your Quality Plus Ford dealers in the all-new 1997 F-150. The first and only full-size pickup with dual airbags and a standard third door. Gene Shaw leads it off for the Phillies here in the eighth. He'll be followed by Kevin Stocker and then a pinch hitter for the pitcher Terry Mulholland.
And the pitcher hiding behind that pole out there in left field for the Phillies is Ken Ryan.
Shaw has walked and struck out. Misses with a slider, one ball and no strikes.
Oh, look at that angle. Isn't that
There's
nice?
Ken Ryan. One one to Shaw.
Phillies only have one left-handed bat available off the bench, and that's the pinch hitter Lee Tinsley. They're carrying five extra men at this point because they're going with a 12-man pitching staff.
Pete Incaviglia has a bat in his hand. And he well could be the pinch hitter.
Yep.
Tapper right back to Bennis, who throws out Shaw. Bennis's slider has been very effective tonight. He's had Philly right-hand hitters reaching for it all night.
Yeah, he has, and he's thrown it in fastball situations a lot tonight to confuse them even more. Here's a breaking ball. As Harry says, there you see Shaw reach for it and hits it's a little comebacker.
Brings on Kevin Stocker. He fly to right center on a good running catch by Willie McGee, and he has struck out. Lee Tinsley now has moved into the on-deck circle. One strike to Stocker.
And Incaviglia is right behind him in the dugout with a bat and a helmet, depending on the situation.
Just foul down the first base side. Now balls and two strikes to Kevin Stocker.
There's Pete. He's ready. He probably would hit if Stocker gets on because a home run will put you ahead. That's what you're always thinking in a game late on the road is not to tie but to get ahead if you can.
Stocker broke his bat on that foul ball. American League scoreboard. Minnesota edged Boston 6-5 today. The Yankees over Kansas City. Jimmy Key won that one 5-3. Seattle behind the big unit over Detroit 9-1. Oakland 11-0 over Milwaukee. Doug Johns got that win for the A's. White Sox got three in extra innings to beat Texas, handing the Rangers their first loss 8-5. California and Toronto tied in the 7th 4-4. Baltimore crushing Cleveland in the 7th 11-2. In that Toronto game, our old buddy Juan Samuel has hit a home run. To the shortstop, Clayton, and Stocker is retired for out number two.
Oh, well, they're going for the tie. Here comes Inca.
Yep. Incaviglia will come out and try to tie this thing with one mighty swing of his bat.
The big unit who you just mentioned had 11 punch-outs today, did that Randy Johnson.
He is nasty. That'll be Incaviglia. Pete's 1-for-4 in the early going this season. A double as a pinch hitter, he is 0-for-2.
Attention, please, back to pitcher Terry Mulholland. Number 9, Pete Incaviglia.
Phillies minor league clubs tonight. Scranton Wilkes-Barre trailing Ottawa 4-0. Well, that's over now. Ottawa's beaten the Barons. Redding trailing Norwich 4-2 in the eighth, and Brevard County leads Clearwater 2-0. Here's Incaviglia with two outs. Eighth inning. 2-1. Tony Mulholland out of the game. Pitched very well. Giving the Phillies 7 strong innings.
Yeah, they just announced 80 pitches for Mulholland, 58 of them strikes.
But we'll leave trailing unless Incaviglia can do something here. One ball and no strikes to Incaviglia.
And are they ever deep? I mean, those three outfielders, all of them are deep. They are not going to let a ball get over their head if they can help, unless it's a homer.
Ground ball in the hole. Nice grab. Clayton sets and guns, but not in time. It'll be a hit. Ball gets loose and goes into the stand, so Incaviglia will take second base. It'll be a hit in the air on Clayton.
Now, what Clayton did there was take an extra step, or maybe even two, and that got him off balance on his throw. And then Sweeney wasn't. Watch right here. Good play was right there. There's one, two, three. Extra steps. And now by the time he gets ready to throw, he's all back-footing it, and he doesn't get anything on it, and it takes a nasty hop off Sweeney and then goes in the dugout.
Kevin Sefcik will come out and pinch run for Pete Incaviglia. Incaviglia's single, just the third hit. And here comes Tony La Russa. And it looks like he has decided to make a pitching change here in the eighth inning. He's going to bring in a left-hander to face Dykstra. Tony Fossas probably. Good job by Andy Bennis. He can win it, he can't lose it. He's responsible for the runner at second, and the fans show their appreciation for his efforts. 7 2/3 strong innings. Pitching change for the Cardinals. We're in the eighth inning, 2-1 St. Louis, back after these messages.
Recently, the camera shop went all blue by offering their employees health plans from Blue Cross and Blue Shield.
Our employees and their families think the coverage is great, and so do I.
They've got a great selection of doctors.
There's no paperwork at all. I can call in customer service and they give me an answer right away.
It's a local company, and I like that.
Great service, no hassles.
Go all blue with personal choice, Keystone HMO, or our traditional plan from Independence Blue Cross and Pennsylvania Blue Shield. The folks you can lean on.
Howdy, partner. They're coming in from Texas looking for action. But our Dutch and our Dude and our Jeffries will be ready for them Houston Heckers when they saunter into the Vet. Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, May 6th, 7th, and 8th, all at 7:35. Mark Witten, my words. We'll play with zeal, and we'll give them all they can handle. So be sure to show up for the showdown at the Broad and Patterson Corral. To order tickets, call 463-1000. That's 463-1000.
Tony Fossas is the new pitcher coming on for the Redbirds. Fossas appearing in his fifth game in the ongoing this season. 0-1, a 2.08 ERA, 4 1/3 innings, 4 hits and 1 run. 3 strikeouts, no walks. He comes in to face a left-hand hitting Lenny Dykstra.
Tony Fossas, 181 left-handed hitters hit off him last year. So he is a specialty pitcher, no doubt about it, a native of Cuba. And he fanned 40 hitters in 36 and 2/3 innings, including 27 left-handed hitters last year. Very effective job for the Cardinals after being in the American League his whole career.
So he comes on with Lenny Dykstra and Mickey Morandini, two left-hand bats scheduled to hit. Kevin Sefcik, the pinch runner at second base, with two outs here in the eighth inning. There you see Andy Bennis, and he is responsible for the runner at second, but pitched very well tonight.
And Royce Clayton is going to live in Ozzie Smith's shadow in this ballpark for a long time, especially with him still on the club. And he did not make, he made a good play on that, but as we've mentioned, he took too long to throw it and then threw it in the dirt, and then his first baseman didn't help him, runner in scoring position, and Bennis is out of the game, probably because of the runner moving to second.
Yeah. Here's Dykstra. He's 0 for 3. He's fly to left, grounded out, and fly to center. One ball and no strikes. breaking ball. Missed it. One ball and one strike. Process will throw a lot of breaking balls.
They have a real veteran bullpen. This guy's 38. Eckersley and Honeycutt are 41. That's an old pen.
Yeah, they do.
But a lot of experience
Jeff
coming
Parrott's
out of there.
Been around a while. He's another one in the bullpen.
One thing about Tony La Russa there when he brings these kind of guys in, Fosses, Honeycutt, Eckersley, they aren't scared. I mean, they've been through the wars, and that's the kind of guy he wants out there right now.
Two balls and a strike to Dykstra. Way outside, 3-1.
Well, he has a batter to play with here. You know, he doesn't want to, I'm sure, but they'd like him to get him out, but they have another left-handed hitter in Mickey Morandini on deck. So he knows he doesn't want to get hurt here by Dykstra because he still has another shot at a left-handed hitter. You would think he'd get a 3-1 breaking ball that he'd try and make Lenny chase.
Dykstra works the walk, and the Phillies have runners at first and second with two outs. For Mickey Morandini, who was 1-for-2, has grounded out, doubled, and scored the Phillies' run and walked.
Yeah, he was not going to let Dykstra hurt him there 3-1. You saw how far outside that pitch was. So far that Dykstra wasn't even tempted to chase it.
So the Phillies with two men on base here in the eighth, two outs, trailing 2-1. T.J. Matthews throwing in St. Louis's bullpen now. And he had a cut and fouled it back.
And Eckersley just got up. He's thrown about two pitches.
T.J. Matthews, number 33. And Dennis Eckersley on the right of your screen. And he threw Morandini a fastball. Now he'll see a lot of breaking pitches.
Yeah, and Morandini was trying to swing early in the count. Mickey doesn't want to get behind this guy because that's when he gets nasty. And unfortunately for him, he's behind as far as you can go.
0-2. Third base side. Still nothing and two to Morandini. Kevin Sefcik, the pinch runner at second. Lenny Dykstra at first with two outs. Eighth inning, Cardinals lead it 2-1.
Gant's playing fairly shallow in left field, as is Lankford in center. Willie McGee figuring he's not going to pull and right is very deep.
Check swing ground ball to Ali Sayah, flips to Clayton for the force, and that will retire the Phillies here in the eighth. No runs, one hit, one error, two men left. We go to the bottom of the eighth. St. Louis leads it 2-1.
It's been said that everyone will be famous for 15 minutes. For some, that's just their daily commute. The Lexus Coupe. Only one station in Philadelphia plays nothing but classic hits. 1029 MGK. The Beatles. Eric Clapton. 1029 MGK. Fleetwood Mac. The Stones. The Doors. 1029 MGK. Elton John. Bruce Springsteen. When you want the classics, turn on Philadelphia's only classic hit station, 1029 MGK.
Good evening, I'm Steve Highsmith. In the news at this hour, following the death today in Wyoming of pilot Jessica Dubroff, Delaware Valleyans sound off on whether a 7-year-old should have been attempting to fly across the country. Israeli aircraft attack a Hezbollah military center in Beirut today. It's the first Israeli attack on the Lebanese capital in 14 years. Those stories and weekend forecast after the Phillies on Inquirer News tonight.
Ken Ryan will be the Phillies' new pitcher, the 27-year-old right-hander. Ryan's third game of the year, no wins, no losses, an 0.0 ERA. He's pitched 3 innings, 1 hit, no runs. 4 strikeouts and 2 walks. And he will be facing the top of St. Louis's order. Luis Alcea, Royce Clayton, and Ray Langford. Alcea is 1-for-3.
Ryan has not pitched since last, I guess it was Saturday night when Hal Morris hit him on the heel with a little smash. He may have missed a few days after that, but the Phillies got rained out Sunday, didn't need him on Monday, and then had the off day and didn't use him again. So he is ready to go. And he had pitched well up until that point.
Always works from the stretch. Starts him with a curveball, very high, 1-ball and 0 strikes. To Alcea. Missing with a fastball, 2-1. And Ryan, who came over along with Lee Tinsley and Glenn Murray. Boston for Heathcliff Slocum, Rick Holyfield, and Larry Wimberly. In the air to left field, Eisenreich right there. Alcea's retired, one down. That'll bring up Royce Clayton. On the National League scoreboard, Montreal got a homer from Shane Andrews in the 11th to beat Pittsburgh 6-5 today. San Diego 2-1 over Atlanta. Andy Ashby besting Greg Maddux in that game in 2 hours and 2 minutes. Houston crunching Cincinnati 9-3 in the 7th. Colorado 6-1 over the Mets in the 4th inning at Coors Field. And Florida and Los Angeles will start a little later. 1 strike to Clayton. He's 1-for-3. Face side, nothing in 2.
Ken Ryan's almost throwing the fastball by Royce Clayton at this point. You wouldn't want to see him throw anything off speed here and speed his bat up, I wouldn't think. He's had 2 real late swings at his fastball.
Well, he's playing that way, playing him well around to the opposite field. And the fastball he just got a piece of. 2 balls and 2 strikes to Clayton. Scheduled to hit in the 9th for the Phillies, Jim Eisenreich, Todd Zeal, and Mark Whitten. Probably they'll be facing Dennis Eckersley, I would imagine.
Oh, yeah.
Another fastball, and he fouled it off. Still 0-2 to Royce Clayton.
First time they'll face him officially. They did face him in spring training. They faced Dennis Eckersley and did pretty well against him. But that means nothing now.
Two strikes to Royce Clayton.
Yeah.
him a curveball and miss with it, 2-2. He balls in two strikes to Clayton with one out. Miles off the fastball, still 2-2. Ken Ryan in his first inning in relief of Terry Mulholland.
This turns into a 1-0 game or 1-run game the way it is right now. I mean, that that home run by Gann will be talked about over and over, but I mean, that was really hard to see, and it took several replays to even see it.
And hit off the yellow line and stayed in play.
And Borders did follow with a two-out single.
You could say that even if it was a double, Borders got a hit and they would have got the run anyhow, but you never know.
Right, and you pitch differently, obviously, yeah. You run on base. You know, it's one of those things you don't know, but at least there was another hit in the inning. These guys just can't put Clayton away. They're talking it over right now. I mean, fastball, he can't get anywhere close to getting around on a fastball. They tried one breaking ball. I think they thought maybe they could lock him with it if it was a strike, but it was not.
Another fastball, still 2-2.
And they're all to the right side because he's just not getting around on it at all.
Cardinals have been playing them close all year. Five of their eight games played so far have been one-run games. We're in another one here, 2-1 St. Louis in the bottom of the eighth. He just keeps fouling off the fastball. He doesn't get around on it, but he does get his bat on it.
You can't put him away. For whatever reason, he's just not able to throw it by him. And yet you don't want to throw a breaking ball to him and go 3-2 if you miss with it. Or, as I mentioned, speed his bat up because your defense has played, you're playing him the other way.
2-2 to Royce Clayton.
See the Phillies with an overshift towards right center on it.
Gave him a curveball and struck him out with a deuce.
Finally decided I'm going to throw one because I can't throw my fastball by him, so I'm going to throw a curveball and hope he chases it. That ball's out of the strike zone, but he swung at it. Here it is. It's a hook, and you see it's a ball, but he chased it.
That's two outs, and that'll bring up Ray Langford. Langford has flied out three times at Jim Eisenreich and left. Strike on the outside corner. Got the curveball over. No balls and two strikes to Langford. Ryan throws strikes. He can be a good one.
You bet.
Has good fastball, good curveball.
Yeah, he can be a little bit nasty to hitters. And, you know, the way he grunts out there, too, he distracts them.
Fastball away, one ball and two strikes.
He's a guy that just looks like he's throwing hard because of all the exertion, the way he rocks back and fires. But we've seen Orion so far, Harry. Not many guys pulling.
Well, even with a good hitter like Langford, who had 25 homers last year, Dykstra shading him to the opposite field with Ryan throwing. curveball missed. 2-2.
And he's really good at playing the count. And now that it went even, he moved two steps to his left. Dykstra is very good that way of playing the outfield. He's very much into the game and playing the count the way good outfielders do.
Another curveball, and he missed with it.
There's a guy who can pull anybody.
Ryan Gant waits on deck.
Now Ryan's gotten himself into a spot here where he may have to throw a fastball.
Hit well to the opposite field, but it is slicing foul. Home run distance, but foul.
You know, watching Langford tonight, Harry, he looks different in that, as you mentioned, he's hit three balls the other way, and he's hitting them this way, even though Ryan, we talked, throws hard. He appears to be waiting longer on the ball right now. You know, he was a guy that used to just hack and strike out a lot.
Yeah.
He looks like he's trying to wait on it more. Whether or not they want that out of him over the course of the year, that'll take some of his power away, but he won't strike out as much if he waits as long as he is. Because he used to be a guy, get the bat head out first and ask questions later.
That's going to be trouble. Infield single for Ray Langford. Chopped it off the plate. And he's a two-out base runner for Ron Gant.
Well, he just, as Harry said, just hit it off the plate. And Langford can fly. There's nothing they could do about this. And now they have to face Gant one more time. And he's had a big night.
Homer, double, and single. He has scored both Cardinal runs. St. Louis leading it 2-1. Corner, it is deep. Whitten against the fence, puts it away, and that will retire the side on a deep opposite field fly ball by Gant. No runs, a hit, no errors, and one lap. We go to the ninth. 2-1 St. Louis.
Seem to have enough of it. Gotta go here, gotta be there. So when do you have time to bank? Midnight? Sunday morning? Why not? At Mellon,
thank you for calling.
We offer 24-hour telephone banking services, hundreds of ATMs, full service offices, plus many Acme Market offices open 7 days a week. Sound convenient? Call 1-800-MELLON-24 and find out how you can bank where you want, when you want. Mellon PSFS.
Baseball's 1996 All-Star Game is coming to Philadelphia this summer. So find out which of the Phillies' 11 different season ticket plans can get you guaranteed seats to the biggest game in the big show. Plus the 5-day All-Star Fan Fest, baseball's ultimate theme park, and the always fun See All the Stars workout day. Plans start at 13 games for just $130. To find out more, call 463-5000.
After 8 innings of play, it's St. Louis 2 and the Phillies 1. Tomorrow at 5, Carl auditions for a job as a TV traffic reporter on Family Matters here on WB17, home of the WB Television Network. St. Louis has T.J. Matthews and Dennis Eckersley looking on. Tony Fossas is still out there. Probably to pitch to Eisenreich, and then they'll bring a right-hander in for Zeal. And Mark Whitten, of course, is a switch hitter.
I wondered if they would do this to see if Jim Fregosi. See, he doesn't have a right-handed bat, except
Kevin
for Jordan.
Right. One ball and no strikes to Eisenreich, who's 0 for 3. He's flied out to left twice and grounded back to the mound.
They have a little chess match going here, he figures that if he leaves Fastis, then Eisenreich's going to stay in the game.
1-1. Eisenreich has good numbers also against Eckersley's, based in the American League, 5 for 10.
Which La Russa would know, of course.
And Fastis high with it, 2-1 to Jim Eisenreich. Fouls it down the left field side, 2 balls and 2 strikes.
You just have to think he's in here for this one batter. That's all.
I think so. Still 2-2 to Jim Eisenreich. Ninth inning. St. Louis on top, 2-1. La Russa brought his pitching coach, Dave Duncan, over here with him.
Well, La Russa is one of the situations that a manager loves. He has the game the way he wants it. And now he has to have his players perform for him. I mean, he has the left-hander, and now he has Eckersley ready to come in and hopefully shut it down. Manager can only do so much. He turns it over to his players. They either make him look good or bad.
And Eckersley has made him look good a lot of times.
Boy, hasn't he?
Was close. Missed the outside corner, a full count.
Looked like a rare fastball, too.
Yeah, it was a heater.
He surprised Eisenreich with a fastball.
Yeah. Eisenreich knocked down by Sweeney. Not in time. Eisenreich beats it out, but Sweeney took extra bases away from Jim Eisenreich. What a fine play by Sweeney, who had come in for Gary Gaetti. It'll be a hit for Eisenreich.
Yeah, and if you don't run like Eisenreich, he doesn't make it. Sweeney was guarding the line, so that's why he's able to get to this ball. See how close he was over towards the line. Makes a great play, and Eisenreich just amazes you how he can run.
Yeah.
Gosh, he got out of that box.
He hadn't lost a step, but now Tony La Russa is going to come out, and he's going to call on Dennis Eckersley, it would appear. No, he's not going to call on Dennis Eckersley.
Matthews, I think.
He's going to call on T.J. Matthews. So we have a pitching change for the Cardinals. We're in the ninth inning. St. Louis leads by a run, 2-1, back after these messages.
I just got a promotion and a cellular phone. Because my little brother got one, too.
Not that I'm competitive.
I got the big calling plan.
I got a local plan. My job's more focused.
At Bell Atlantic 9X Mobile, cellular service isn't one size fits all. From phone features to calling plans, you get services that fit your life.
I also got voicemail.
You did?
Hmm?
I want that.
Bell Atlantic 9X Mobile.
Al, yeah. We got a player.
I'd like the lottery ticket.
Yeah, she is a player. She's a big player.
I'll say, straight.
You're nuts. Straight and backs it up with a pair.
428 and boxes.
Oh, she's a boxer.
Ding, 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 ding.
Bring it. All right, okay. All right.
Oh,
all right. Adrian.
You know her?
No, I don't know her, Ed. I was making a literary reference.
Pennsylvania Lottery's daily number. Play a pair, box, or play it straight.
T.J. Matthews, the 26-year-old, 6'2", a 200-pounder from Belleville, Illinois. High-round draft pick, a 36-round draft pick in the June 92 draft by St. Louis. But he has pitched well so far for Tony La Russa. This will be his fifth game already. No wins, no losses, an 0.0 ERA. He's given up three hits in five innings, six strikeouts, and four walks. Last year at Louisville, he was 9-4, 2.70 ERA. And he came up with the Cardinals at the end of the year. This will be his first appearance against the Phillies.
Yeah, he came along last year after the Phillies. The Phillies didn't play the Cardinals, I think, after July last year, early August. So they never saw him. And he did a very good job for St. Louis setting up Tom Hankey, who had a heck of a year for the Cardinals last year and then retired after the season. So, you know, what they know about him basically is from reports.
Looks like he throws a splitter. It looks like that's the pitch he's throwing now as he takes his warm-up tosses. Dennis Menke, the hitting instructor. And Todd Zeal will be the first one to face him. He is grounded out, single to drive in the Phillies run and grounded out. Jim Eisenreich at first base. Nobody out here in the ninth. Phillies trail by a run. Mark Whitten waiting on deck. One ball and no strikes to Todd Zeal. He's trying to do something here in the ninth, trailing by a run. Base. Terry Mulholland, who pitched seven good innings looking on. Missing with a breaking ball, two balls and no strikes. Matthews, judging by the numbers, you take a chance with him that he can walk batters, and of course that's something Eckersley doesn't do. It's borderline, got the call, two balls and a strike.
It's hard to believe he got that pitch too, the way Borders jumped too. I mean, Pat Borders didn't help him at all get that pitch, and he still got it. Watch him jump. This normally, when you jump like this as a catcher, you don't get it. Look at his whole body move.
A little bit wide from here, but it's 2-1 now to Todd Zeal.
DJ Matthews has not shown his move yet.
No, he just shows the step off.
Fake.
Yeah. Breaking ball, 3-1 to Zeal. He should get a fastball to hit here. It's Mark Whitten waiting on deck.
What's a fastball away?
Oh, that was away again. He's giving him a part of the outside part of the plate and then some, and Zeal not happy with the call. It's a full count now.
Plus, Borders is jumping all over the place.
Three and two to Todd Zeal. Eisenreich goes, strikeout. Out at second base is Jim Eisenreich, so it's a strikeout double play. really hurts the Phillies.
Well, they wanted to stay out of the ground ball double play, so they gambled with Eisenreich running that they could get the base out of it. Eisenreich goes. High fastball. Borders got rid of in a hurry. Throws kind of a grenade down there, and it's bang, bang. Thought he made it with a naked eye, and now he's safe.
Yep.
He was safe. I thought he was safe, but, yep. You know, he's called out.
Missed by Jeff Kellogg, the second base umpire, and here is Mark Whitten.
Kellogg's not had a good night in a couple of key situations. He's the umpire, of course, has the call in the outfield on Gant's ball, and then that one.
Whitten is grounded out, grounded into a double play, and struck out. Foul down the left field side. Now balls and two strikes. Whitten trying to keep the Phillies' hopes alive here. Fly ball in the gap in right center field, and Willie McGee chases it down and makes the running catch. Willie McGee can still go get him, and he did that one to end the ball game. A fine running grab by McGee.
Willie McGee did this twice tonight. They're playing very, very deep for the outfielders to prevent an extra base hit, and that's why you do it at this stage of the game, because he's able to cut it off. Early in the game, he can't get to that ball.
For the Phillies in the ninth, no runs, a hit, no errors, and none left. St. Louis wins a squeaker 2-1 over the Phillies here at Busch Stadium, and we'll be back with the totals and a recap in just a moment.
Before you buy that new Ford Explorer, let's compare it to this Chevy Blazer. Come with me.
You'll find Blazer offers the largest displacement V6 in any truck standard. And right now, a special factory offer means you could drive a new Blazer for only $299 a month. That's right, lease a 96 Blazer with four-wheel drive, four doors, air conditioning, stereo, and more, all for just $299 a month. What are you waiting for?
See your Chevy Geo dealers today.
Hey, boss.
Bob?
Gentlemen?
Frankie!
Hi, fellas.
Hi, Lee. Do they really think they can pass as him?
No. People know the genuine article when they see it, like the genuine Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages. It has the information and choices that make shopping easier. 9 out of 10 use it. The genuine Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages.
Hey, boys. Lost my way to Vegas.
Bell Atlantic, the heart of communication.
It's him!
He travels for days to the farthest reaches of South America. He carefully selects only the finest beans. And after they're roasted to perfection, only then will you hear him say,
"Time to make the coffee."
Dunkin' Donuts coffee, brewed fresh all day long. Now you can get fresh brewed coffee and a freshly baked cinnamon bun for a great price.
Celebrate the Fanatics' birthday with zany mascots from around the country. Fans 14 and under receive a colorful Fanatic beach towel. Compliments of Tasty Cake when the Phillies play the Cardinals Sunday, April 21st at 1:35. Call 463-1000.
Back at Busch Stadium before 20,049, the Cardinals over the Phillies 2-1. For St. Louis, 2 runs, 8 hits, 1 error, they left 5. Phil's a run, 4 hits, no errors with 4 left. Andy Benes gets the win. He's 1-0. The loss goes to Terry Mulholland, 0-1. T.J. Matthews records his first save. Ron Gant was the big hitting star. 3 hits, including his third home run of the year, as St. Louis won it by a score of 2-1 here at Busch Stadium. We'll be back with more from Busch Stadium right after these messages.
What will you do with the money you save at Speedy?
I saved $49 on my Honda's brakes, so I got my husband surfing lessons.
I saved $44 on my brake job over the dealer, and I'm keeping it.
Right now, get 20% off all brake parts at Speedy.
I save $53 on my minivan's brakes. I guess I got number 99 here, skating lessons.
And at Speedy, you never need an appointment. Speedy for brakes, Speedy for savings. Guaranteed.
This rendezvous, the islands of the Bahamas, it just keeps getting better.
Call Liberty Travel at 1-800-610-3000.
Andy Bennis outduels Terry Mulholland as St. Louis wins it by a score of 2-1. Our Chevrolet player of the game is Ron Gant, 3-for-4, a homer, double, and single. Gant scored both Redbird runs. He is our Chevrolet player of the game. Our next telecast here on the Phillies Television Network will be tomorrow night for the second of this four-game series with the Cards. We'll be on the air at 8 o'clock. Check your local listings for the games carried in your area. Mike Williams going against Tom Urbani. Once again, the final score, St. Louis 2 and the Phillies 1 for Rich Ashburn and Chris Wheeler. Harry Callis saying thanks a lot for watching. We'll talk to you tomorrow night from Busch Stadium on the Phillies Television Network.
It's been brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers, who remind you friends know when to say when. The Bell Atlantic Yellow Pages, the book 9 out of 10 people use and keep and count on. Mellon PSFS, the official bank of the Phillies, featuring full-service evening and seven-day banking. Your local Chevrolet Geo dealers, and by Independence Blue Cross and Pennsylvania Blue Shield, the insurance companies you can lean on.